in this final section of Module 3. We will now summarize the WWC research ratings available for group design study findings. The process used to decide who receives the intervention and who does not is a critical feature of the study that will affect the WWC's level of confidence in the study's claim that the intervention produced the observed findings. Depending on the type of study design used in its execution, this review may include up to 5 steps when reviewing eligible group design studies. This includes assessing whether the study authors used trustworthy outcome measures and whether the study had any confounding factors. These 2 steps are grouped together in the handbook, but are really 2 separate steps in the review process. This also includes assessing the process used for assignment to conditions. And under certain scenarios, the WWC examines compositional change, as well as whether the intervention and comparison groups were similar when the study began, and whether they remain similar throughout the duration of the study. This phase carries considerable weight in the review process because the WWC makes consequential decisions about the study at this stage, which affect the research rating of its findings. Because of this, usually several WWC certified reviewers contribute to each study review, supported by the review team leadership, and in many cases, also supported by content experts, methodologists, and external experts. Importantly, when reviewing findings for assigning WWC research ratings, the WWC evaluates each eligible outcome for each sample separately. Findings from randomized controlled trials are potentially eligible to receive the highest rating of meets WWC standards without reservations. This research rating means that the WWC has the highest level of confidence that the intervention caused the observed effect. But findings from RCTs may be downgraded to lower research ratings based on characteristics and implementation of that design. For QEDs, the highest possible research rating their findings can receive is meets WWC standards with reservations, given that the non-random allocation of units to conditions means that the WWC has a lower degree of confidence that the intervention caused the observed effect. Time for our first knowledge check in this module. A study investigated the effects of a summer bridge program for 150 first-year incoming students at a community college located in a southeastern state. The sample was 46% male and 54% female. 13% of the students were Pell Grant recipients. The students who participated in the summer bridge program showed significantly higher performance on a spring post-test when compared to their pre-test scores. The pre-test scores were collected immediately prior to the implementation of the intervention, based on the WWC standards for assignment to conditions in group design studies. What is the highest WWC research rating a finding from this study is eligible to receive? Your answer options are A, meets WWC standards without reservations, B, meets WWC standards with reservations, C, does not meet WWC standards, and D, this study is not eligible for review and cannot receive a research rating. You may want to pause the video while you think about your answer. The correct answer is D. This study would not be eligible for WWC review as a group design study because it does not have a comparison group. Instead, this study uses a single group pre-test, post-test design to assess the effects of the intervention. Remember that the WWC does not review evidence from single group pre-test, post-test designs under its group design standards because these designs are unable to provide trustworthy evidence of effectiveness, and these designs include a confounding factor between time and study condition. Knowledge check 2. A study examined the relationship between time spent on computer-based science instruction and student science achievement. The study authors collected data from 10 fourth grade classrooms in one school district. In January, March, and April, trained observers visited each classroom daily for 1 week to observe science instruction. Each of the 10 classrooms, teachers observed between 20 to 50% of weekly instruction time to assess whether it involved computer-based instruction. At the end of the school year, the students completed the district's standardized science assessment. Based on an analysis of data from the 10 classrooms, the study authors reported that spending more time on computer-based instruction was correlated with higher levels of student science achievement. Based on the WWC Standards for Assignment to Conditions and Group Design Studies, what is the highest WWC research rating a finding from this study is eligible to receive? Your answer options are A. Meets WWC standards without reservations. B. Meets WWC standards with reservations. C. Does not meet WWC standards. And D. This study is not eligible for review and cannot receive a research rating. You may want to pause the video while you think about your answer. The correct answer is D. This study is not eligible for WWC review as a group design study because the study does not include distinct intervention and comparison groups. Instead, this study uses a correlational design to examine the association between time spent in online instruction and student science achievement. This type of correlational design is not eligible for WWC review as a group design study. This concludes the third module in the WWC Group Design Standards training. Let's review what we discussed in this module. We provided an overview of the types of study designs that are eligible for review under the WWC Group Design Standards, that is, randomized controlled trials and quasi-experimental designs. We also summarized the WWC research rating that these different types of group designs are eligible to receive under the Group Design Standards. Remember that you can access all of the resources mentioned in this module on the WWC website, whatworks.ed.gov.